Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Flummery. This is our first broadcast in full complement here. All of the talent is present and accounted for and ready to input, bounce off of one another, give you about an hour-ish of nonsense, attitude, opinion. And if you don't like it, well, that's too bad because it's ours. You can't say nothing about it. So, So we got this is Scuba Steve talking to you at the moment. To my left is Adam Frosty. Say hi, Adam.
Either one. Hey, it's Frosty. What's up?
Hey, Frosty.
And of course, the smooth, silky boy at the end of the table there is, of course, Lance.
The flavorings.
When you say smooth and silky, are you talking about my college swimming days or?
Or
right now?
Were you swimming just last week?
Well, I used coconut butter yesterday. So
where do you find a coconut this time of year?
I have friends that go on vacation.
Yeah, I'm bringing them back
all day
west. It's got 40 holes in it already.
Well, I think when you come back from Key West, like there's a point between Key Largo and the mainland where there's a fruit check.
Don't be important anymore.
I'll give you a fruit check.
Yeah, no wonder nobody can get off the islands.
You're stuck. What, is that a banana in your pants?
Sir, you can't go through twice.
It's got its own zip code.
Hell yeah. It's MV3. MV3, the big three together.
What's that?
That's us, dude. Oh, we're MV3.
Season 1, episode 3.
Oh, the Flum, chum.
The Flum.
So how was your guys' this weekend?
Good. Cold. Yeah. Cold.
Yeah, we reached a balmy negative 17 to 22 degrees.
Yeah. That's like car-killing weather.
Mine actually worked, started out fine.
Yeah. We're losing alternators and batteries everywhere. Yeah. Is that...
Absolutely, yeah.
I saw you brought the two nicer cars in to stay warm, and then you brought the older one to...
Well, I've changed the... It's no longer the Nissan Pathfinder. It's the Nissan Problem Finder.
Uh-oh.
Still the
oh, no.
Fucking windshield wiper fucking jets don't work. And it's like, come on. So I was trying to drive home the other day. So on my way home from work, I make sure I had a big thing of water. So I was like... Yeah, you know, I put brand new wiper blades on, so it does a killer job after the fact, but god damn.
Oh, that sucks.
What was the main problem with that car?
Well, the first thing was that smoking on startup because of a design flaw in the valve cover that created an area where gunk could build up and then eventually would choke out the PVC valve and PCV valve, pollution control. PCV valve, and then cause it to sense things wrong, load up the motor, and then burn a bunch of crap out the ass end when you started it.
It sounds like a bad night of drinking with a lot of tacos.
Right? Not the good tacos either. Or, yeah. No. The straight through is.
What time is it? Oh, God, do I have to get up this early? It's 1.
So you don't want to talk about Rogue One, Steve?
Rogue One.
Oh, absolutely.
What do you, I mean, Adam and I saw it this weekend together, so.
No, okay.
I'll probably be seeing it in about a week.
No spoilers.
No spoilers.
Everybody just don't turn off your computers. There's no spoilers.
Well, is there any inquisitive questions you have about the movie?
No, because honestly, I'm not following the story that closely with all the new characters and stuff. I mean, it's like, okay, well, I saw this. I know what happens up to this point, so. Now the extra detail is, it doesn't do much for me. I didn't read the books either.
Right.
So, it's just another kick-ass sci-fi flick, you know?
Yeah.
Hopefully with no, like, Jar Jar Binks style people or any of that.
What did I say when we sat down in the theater?
You have to fart?
No, after that. We sat down. Lance and I saw Rogue One on Saturday.
That's the day.
The late night. Late night.
Yeah, we actually got out of there on Sunday morning.
Nice.
Yeah. And
it was an all-nighter.
We saw a preview and I was like, Misa wanna see that. The fucking evil look that you gave me.
Well, the best part about it is this dude that was like getting up to walk in front of me. Okay. Like it really mattered, but he would duck down.
Before the movie.
So the previews are going on, and he's like scrouching down and walking in front of me. I'm like, you're still blocking my view. It doesn't matter.
First, you said, like, why? Loud. I don't know. You maybe had stuff in your ears. It was louder enough for everybody to hear. You're like, You know, he doesn't have to bow. Why does he have to bow down? He doesn't need to, like he's just being nice. And then he goes, if he wants to be nice, and get down on your hands and knees and crawl.
Nice.
Yeah, I just didn't, I just didn't get why he was, you
know. We were campy.
Yeah, we were very campy.
He was, it was weird. They were weird.
Yeah.
And she had the LED flash on her.
Yep, and I was, yep, and it went off to two or three times.
Oh, FHL, fuck her life. It pisses me off so bad. But you saw me turn my phone off.
Yeah.
I sat down, the previews, I checked a couple sexts that I got.
I just did, I turned my volume down, you know?
And then I can't do that, otherwise I would. Oh. And then, I'll be here like,
do you still have your iPhone?
Yeah, yeah, I got a new screen.
Oh.
But, where was I? Where was I?
Oh, her lights were going off.
Oh, her light went off, and then he was sitting with them, and it was weird. There were three people together, all friends, obviously, and they were just weirdos. I was like, what the heck?
Yeah.
And then the Jolly Green Giant walked by a couple times.
Yep.
He was like 8 feet tall.
I'm like,
probably 18 years old.
Yeah, and I gave him props. I'm like, hey, at least he didn't duck down.
Yeah, it's like,
what would that matter?
Right. He knows. It's like, this doesn't help.
Yeah. Just be quick about it. Don't linger.
Right. And then, you know, you get in those new chairs and the feet go all the way out. Yeah, and my feet go out like almost to the glass.
Right.
So
yeah. I'm like, on somebody's head.
Back and forth.
Burning out the chairs.
Oh, speaking of movies, did you guys see the new trailer for Blade Runner?
No, I don't want to see it.
Really?
I don't know. It's like,
it's got Ryan Gosling. He's in The Notebook, man.
You love that.
I do. I cry to myself to sleep every time I watch that movie.
Well, let's be fair. The movie has nothing to do with the movie. You just, that's what you do. Cry yourself to sleep.
That and masturbate.
Right, right. Well,
while you're trying to fall asleep. Maybe that's why you're crying, is you can't fall asleep because you play with your dick all the time. I want to go to sleep.
I tried counting sheep, and then I tried humping sheep.
One, two.
And that didn't work out so well.
Are you to the point where it's like, you kind of like, you get even frustrated when you can't get it up beating off?
Get angry with yourself.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so desensitized.
The passion is gone.
Right.
The passion is gone and the prostate's inflamed.
I want a divorce from my hand.
From me.
Okay, Rogue One. Let's keep talking about Rogue One.
What do you want to talk about? I mean, we're not going to give any spoilers, so what's
no,
really
we're not
going to
give spoilers, but I will. This is not a spoiler, but.
So, what generation, like, ships and stuff do they have?
Okay, that's a good question.
Your X-Wings, your
Y-Wings,
all
your.
Yes,
it's
got.
Okay, so. It's overlapping. Here's four, right?
Yep. Yeah, it's like 3.5 or something.
It's actually like 3.9. It's 8.
Okay.
And it overlaps like this.
Hmm.
Well, no, it goes right up to the beginning.
Yeah, it's pretty much like this. Yeah. It's not like a 3.5. It's more closer to 4 than anything.
Hmm.
Right, but it runs right into 4.
It does.
Like right at the beginning of 4 is where.
But, yeah, you're right. That's correct. Let's get our timeline straight here, buddy.
Sorry. Hey, what the? No. Okay. Two things, though. So
they introduced a new ship.
That was
it's
awesome.
Called the U-Wing.
And that was one of my things, right?
Right.
I was really pumped. Well, you remember from last week, I was really pumped to see the new ship, and that was cool.
Right.
I loved that. Then, like the cargo ATCT or whatever it's called now, I didn't really care if it was
the AT-AT walker.
Yeah. And then, but.
It was cool, and I mean, you'll see it in the previews. It's when it's going through the forest and they're running away from it. That's a pretty sweet scene. So
that's really cool.
That's not a spoiler alert.
No.
That's in the previews.
Well, but, I just thought for something, you know, when they make the cool ships that are just elegant as hell, and then they got this big fucking stumbling rhinoceros thing.
Right. Well, they did that in the prequels. They did that. Everything was nice and sleek and 50s, 60s looking sleek and whatever.
Yeah.
And then they get back to the clunky, and it's. Lucas, I don't think Lucas really thought that out before, but
Disney.
He should have given me a call.
The guy who made the movie really did a good job of it's. You're gonna see. It's gonna look like Episode 4.
Yeah,
it's really
new,
cool.
New
like
age, but it's still gonna have that feel.
Sure.
The door handles, like everything.
The controls and the Death Star and all that stuff. It's all got that. All the buttons and everything.
Cool.
Just,
the guys had those big scoop helmets too.
Yeah. Still. What I will say about this, though, the story.
Yep. They had a few of those in there.
What Gareth Edwards did and the storyline was amazing, and it tied everything together, and cool. It was amazing.
So did you guys like read the books and follow the movies and all that jazz, or were you movie
well there
first
was this this back? Story wasn't a book. The story was actually it was an idea from a guy from ILM Industrial Light and Magic. And he heard of the stories that were throwing Disney was throwing around for Star Wars, and he was like, "Oh, these are all dumb." So him and a group from ILM came together, together, and like threw a 30-minute story prop to Kennedy, Catherine Kennedy, or whatever. She's like the president of Lucasfilm / Disney or whatever, and she loved it, and she went with it, and so they took that as the first story. It's not actually a book. It's just it's an idea and a storyline that came from somebody that works on Star Wars or other movies through ILM.
It was great.
Cool.
I loved it. I read a review.
I actually felt better about it leaving that than I did The Force Awakens the first time.
I remember. I loved The Force Awakens, but for this movie, for me, it was something where I heard somebody say that you know, before I saw it, they saw the preview, like a guy I listened to on the radio, he saw a preview for it, or a, you know, what's it called, a premiere for it, and he said it was like a standalone. It was good enough for a standalone. You don't have to love Star Wars.
No, it doesn't.
It's a great movie, good storyline, good characters.
Cool.
And they don't have to be introduced in any certain way. And that was kind of what pissed me off about some of the reviews I read. There was this one guy.
Oh, people don't understand it.
It's like they're trying to be, the reviewers are trying to be like, oh, you know.
You're not making a dime, shithead.
Yeah. I'm responsible to make sure, you know, I got to be the voice of reason.
Right.
Then they try too hard. Somebody has to. And it's like, no, the movie was fucking good. I mean, don't
leave it be
a tool. Just, there's only one reviewer I read and agree with about 85%, and that's Colin Covert, I don't know, but it's Covert, and he's a guy, he does like the Twin Cities, one of the Twin Cities papers, and I'll always read his if I'm thinking about seeing a movie, and he's always dead on. I did not read his review for this one because I wasn't on the fence about it, but he's always dead on, so I'd love, like, but other reviewers, I would say I agree with like 50% of what they say, maybe.
Yeah.
So, this guy's dead on. We should hang, we should have a beer.
I already have one. So does Scuba.
I do. Actually, mine's out. I got to get another one.
Jeez. We're all drinking beers.
That was quick.
I started before you guys. You are dicking about.
Don't be nervous, Steve.
Oh, I had to blow my nose. Okay.
Cool. We did this already. Don't worry. We take beer breaks.
Oh, yeah, I heard it. I did listen to the entire hour and 41 minutes or whatever the hell it was.
We're not on a televised broadcast here where we only get so many minutes. Scuba is breaking open a 60-minute IPA. Is that Dogfish Head there, buddy?
Yes, sir.
Oh,
yum.
Gotta go to Wisconsin to get it.
Really? They don't have it here?
No.
Did you go specifically to Wisconsin to pick up a beer?
No, we had
beer?
our Euchre family Christmas yesterday at my sister's house in Hudson, so I always make it a point to swing into Chicone's.
Chiquan's.
Is that in Hudson?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah, right off of Carmichael. You know where it is, Adam?
That's familiar? Yeah, I used to live in River
Tucked
Falls
back in
for
that corner next to the Country Market or whatever the hell that.
Yep.
But if you're looking for an obscure beer, that's the place
you
to
know, another
decent prices too compared to like down by the river. I won't say their name, but
yeah.
Oh, I know what you're talking about. In this little strip mall there.
Both. Yeah. Yes. Well, there's the really nice place that I do like, and I go to their beer dabbler, but then there's another place, one of the bars that really gouges you, and then the strip mall one I haven't been to, so I can't say, but yeah, the river ones are obviously more expensive, but up on the hill.
I usually don't stop at the beer store. I'm usually just at a bar in Hudson.
Right.
It just comes out of this tube.
Yeah.
That's going into my vein.
I was going to ask you guys another question about Chihuahuas. No, I can't remember what the hell it was.
Well, I had something to say, but
did you?
I got lost in translation of everybody talking. Shit happens, so whatever.
Yeah, that happens. Well, one thing I really loved about it, and this is kind of the last note I had, honestly, on the whole deal, was there's bit characters in episode 4, and there's bit characters in a Star Wars story, Rogue One. And so there, something that happened in 4 that I loved was those bit characters were, normally you're just like, oh, they're saying something, you know, to keep the story moving. But the bit characters were like lovable, awesome, badass. You know what I mean? Like the generals and the admirals and the, okay. you know, and some of the pilots and stuff. And the same thing, what I loved is the same thing. So there was higher value in that movie for the bit characters for me
okay.
in 4. And that's what I remember a lot about that movie is how much I loved those guys. And then they do the same thing for me in Rogue One. So that for me, and it's something weird, you know, everybody likes their own little things.
Yeah.
Like I like the vehicles and I like the characters.
Right.
And I like the building of the characters, but these were, you know, lots of new characters and stuff. But then some of the older characters, some Star Wars characters that you know are in it, obviously you know that's going to happen, so that's not a spoiler, but they're great characters. They're cool. Awesome. Like the generals and the admirals and stuff, you know what I mean? And then what's the one, Mon Mothma or Mon...
Mon Moth, whatever, but she's played by another chick that looks exactly like her.
Just awesome. She did a great job. And they took her out of... what movie did they take her out of? Remember that thing we read? And they took her out of one of them, her part. It just got, you know, ended up on the cutting room floor, but they had to have her in this one. She did an awesome job.
Cool.
Yeah.
So I loved that. That's a good example. That's one where that somebody that's so important, what they're doing, what they're saying, is a huge impact on the movie, even though they have like 4 friggin' lines, you know?
Yeah.
So I loved that. That was
there was a lot of traveling to different planets in that movie.
Yeah.
It was like...
Oh, that got panned. I read 100 reviews.
Yeah, there was a lot of traveling on planets, and there's a lot more planets in this one than any other ones.
Did they like open it up like they do most of them with a passing ship, so you get that instant? Everything's thumping.
First scene was a planet. I forget what planet it was, and
can it crush?
One down.
Oh,
nice. Sorry, go on, Lance. I'm sorry.
And they didn't do I'll tell you this. They didn't do the text scroll.
Oh no.
No.
Oh.
Oh, I know what. The settle down.
Spoiler.
No, that's okay.
Yeah.
It is. I mean, it's shocking, but yeah.
And this is the first movie they did without John Williams.
Back holder, if you care.
This is the first movie they did without John Williams doing the score,
the music.
Yeah.
Didn't they just regurgitate everything from the previous one?
He used the material and some of the, you know, the phrasing and stuff for the Star Wars themes.
Yeah.
But he did his own thing too. So he wanted to tie it in with what John Williams was doing, but right. made it his own in a way.
Excellent.
I love that.
That's what I was going to say earlier that I forgot
cool.
that this was the first movie without John Williams doing it. And we all know that Vader's in it, and that was pretty badass. Like to hear James Earl Jones do Vader's voice again, mm-hmm. and the guy that acted him out, like he wasn't in there very, very long. Which is fine, but mm-hmm. what he did and whoever acted him out as far as like his actions, and then hearing James Earl Jones do mm-hmm. Vader again was pretty sweet.
Would
yeah. And I don't think you're gonna get another one of those opportunities with him. He's up there in age, man.
You're absolutely correct.
You know what else is up there in age? That passed away yesterday.
Alan Thicke.
Zsa Zsa Gabor.
Oh, no, I did see her too.
99 years old.
Slapping death.
Right.
She couldn't wait one more year and hit the hundo mark.
Did you hear about
that's a hard 99, I think.
Did you hear about the woman who tweeted about Alan Thicke? She's an actress.
I'm sorry.
She's an actress, and she tweeted it was, and like I said, we're not gonna get I don't think we're gonna get too political on the show or anything, but this is just people have a big uproar because somebody said something stupid. Whatever. Well, she's like Alan Thicke, maybe he wanted to go before the Trumpocalypse, she called it. I'm like, okay, so
that a girl.
But, and, you know,
that's going to piss everybody off.
Well, and
that's
it does. Dumb. And it's like, why?
Ignorant slut. What the fuck is wrong with you?
So they get mad at
that
her.
That doesn't even bother me.
It doesn't bother me either.
No, should it bother?
People get so mad about, you know, when people have a stupid tweet. It's like millions of billions of drunk tweets out there right now. So don't worry about it.
You know what I hate?
But
people that do shit to get attention. I'm not talking about this podcast because that's not an attention getter at all.
No, nothing. No.
We're just doing this as a public service.
Right. Gets me out of the house one more night out of the week.
After this, we have to clean about a mile of highway on 52.
Yeah.
In my orange jumpsuit.
We can't tell you what we did.
No, but it was really fun.
Well, we had to do something next to get where we're at, right?
We did. I mean, we've succeeded.
Right.
We've succeeded. Yeah. We're there.
All those robberies came in, you know, came in handy.
This is a big time.
Right?
Stealing people's hearts.
Oh.
Yes. Steve hated that one.
You just hurt. Oh.
Steve hated that one, everybody.
Zsa Zsa Gabor.
She,
99.
So everybody's like, oh, too soon, right? To tweet. So I wonder, what should we say that's too soon about Zsa Zsa Gabor?
I have nothing.
I was going to say.
I haven't thought about Zsa Zsa Gabor since the 80s.
When did Ava die? When did her sister die? That was a while ago.
Oh, I don't even know.
Because they were twins.
Oh, yeah.
Ava and Zsa Zsa. Yeah.
I didn't realize
Zsa Zsa
that.
Zsa was the one that was always bitch slapping the cops and getting all rowdy up in the
hills. I remember that.
Zsa Zsa was slappy. Yes. Okay, I was going to ask you.
That was like early 90s or something like that, mid-90s?
Roughly. Yeah, I think you're pretty close there, because I'm sure she was in, you know, well, she would have been in her 70s.
Yeah.
Spring chicken out there, high karateing up the cops, you know.
Come here, I love
punch. I'm going to bust your nose.
Yeah. That's California cops probably, because the cops I know would be like, just knock it off.
Lady.
You know, you're going to take her in for a little slabity slap.
Get in the squad. I'll take you home, right. You dumbass. Stop doing stupid things.
Oh, man.
Did anybody get arrested this weekend?
Not me.
Nope. I evaded police. It was awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah. When you were coming out of Hudson?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Was that in the Rogue?
No, it's not the Rogue. It's the Problem Finder.
Oh, the Problem Finder. Yeah, level up.
Yeah, no, actually, because those things don't work, I took my car into work today, so I miss my car. I love my car.
What kind of car do you have?
It's a 2002 Audi S8.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, that's right.
Right? S8 I?
Nope, just S8.
Sweet.
Oh, yeah, that thing's badass.
Wow, that'd be fun.
He took me on 494, and he's like, you want to see what this thing can do? And I'm like, all right. So I think we're literally doing 120 miles an hour.
It comes pretty fast.
And he was bobbing and weaving out of cars, and I was crapping myself. And he's like, don't worry, this is one of the most, safest cars.
So if we crash.
At 100, though, does that matter?
Into a ball of flame. Melted aluminum.
Paul Walker style.
Right.
Oh, too soon.
Rest in peace, Paul Walker.
R.I.P.
Peace.
He crashed. Yeah,
well, he's not in Fast and Furious 8.
How many of those are they going to make again?
I don't know. I think they're going to make like 46 of them.
Yeah, they're going to keep squeezing it.
46.
Until eventually all the key players just flat drop out.
No, they're in wheelchairs racing each other down the fucking hospital hallway or wherever they're at. Nursing home hallway.
Yeah, until Luda's not sexy anymore, that's when they'll shut her down.
It's all Vin Diesel now, man. That's all it's all about. Right.
Well, they have The Rock in there.
Yeah. Mm. I don't know if he'll do another one, because I heard that there was some, not that I want to get all People magazine-ish, I heard there's some attitude between him and Vin Diesel.
Mm, that makes sense. Couple of meatheads, probably.
Yeah. Exactly. Steroids.
And The Rock's way much bigger than Vin Diesel, though. He would destroy
him. Yeah,
I'm sure Vin Diesel can put away.
Oh, you're gonna get hurt.
Few people.
Yeah,
but
you're
like,
gonna get hurt.
Rock is not a small dude.
No, he's just big.
He's one of the biggest guys I've seen on film.
Yeah,
pretty awesome.
And he's tall.
Right.
Like, he's got to be taller, my height or taller.
Yeah, he's like 6'5", isn't he?
Yeah, I would imagine.
6'4", 6'5". I mean, and
he was in the NFL, wasn't he? He played college
briefly.
Ball, I know.
I think he lost his chance because he was down in like Florida State playing, and fucked up his knee. Yeah.
I knew it was close.
I think he was like, there was propositions and ideas of him going to the NFL, and it was talking, but he busted out his knee early on. So
he went into the WWF. Yeah. That was a smart idea. Take the pads and shit off, and now bounce your ass around.
That's probably even worse than the NFL.
Absolutely. That's what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
Do you think that was why he's famous now, or do you think he could have just went and been an actor?
No, I think that was, you know how there's certain channels on getting into things?
Yeah,
right.
That was his channel and getting into acting.
My thing, what I'm going to do to get famous, I'm going to start, this is the best way I heard it, I'm going to start in porn. Mm. And then
you're like the bigger Ron Jeremy.
They'll make you like an actor eventually. I heard.
Yeah, because I hear that
another public service now.
Oh, cool.
That happens for all the women that go into that, right?
Yeah.
The only person that I think that really kind of worked out for is Rebecca De Mornay, right?
I don't know. I didn't know she was in any pornographic materials. Her?
Yeah, from Risky Business.
She was in Risky Business, but she did...
She did like she was hard R.
Yeah, she was 16 or 17 when she did that. And they found... Yeah, so she lied about her age.
Is that a pirate movie?
It's not a Debbie Does Dallas movie, that's for sure.
Butt pirate.
Yeah, the only person that I know of... Well, I'm sure there's cameos from other porn stars that have made it in movies and stuff, obviously. But
well, look at what Jenna Jameson did, for Christ's sake.
Yeah.
She's a skillion billionaire.
Yeah, but she vested into the porn industry, and she's like her deal is like one of the bigger entertainment companies in porn, right? That's what I believe it is. I think she's got one of the bigger hands in... into the porn industry, like that's her thing. Like she got into the business side of it.
She's like the Walt Disney.
I know a lot about this.
You said hands in the porn industry. That was good.
I really don't, but this is from things I've read over the years.
Moist.
Cool.
You already said that, Adam.
I know. I'm gonna do it. A lot.
Is that your word for today? Is moist.
It's just every. It
it's like
off.
Every week. No, you're not doing that, are you?
I love it, man. That's so gross.
Especially when you're right in here.
Let's both do it.
Yeah. Did you guys just see the thing I paste on? Speaking of little noises like that, did you see the Star Wars thing without music that I posted?
I did not look at it yet.
Oh, my God. When they're getting the medals and stuff?
Yeah.
And they're just walking
here.
Chewbacca's like... yeah,
just random noises.
Yeah, and you can just hear him walking down. And then, like, when Luke bends over to get his medal, you can hear his leather jacket just go... you know, like...
Did they really record it that
no,
way?
No, but I want to do that. Oh, I want to grab movie clips now and do that because I have the capability of doing that,
is that
stuff
right?
Here. Yeah.
Oh, the bad lip sync. Oh, and all that.
Yeah. Just do something like from Heat, you know, like a scene from Heat. I can't think of one, like a particular scene at the moment, but it would be so funny
because if you made like the gunshot sound like bubbles, like
or the dinner scene, you know how they're all at dinner and having dinner scene,
yeah,
and they're like everybody's together, but like Robert De Niro realizes he doesn't have a chick with him, and he's like missing
out.
It's
all melancholy.
Yeah, that would be a funny scene to do. like the chick responding to the dude, like leaning over, like, "Hey, you're so funny and cute when you touch my coochie," you know, things like that. That would be fun to do.
It would be fun.
I think we should do that.
I think
that should be an adventure
for the get like a machine gun. It's like. Like in the, you know, when they rob the bank and they're running away in the big, like, promenade area or whatever, you know, the big stone area. And then they're just capping off the fucking machine guns like at each other. And then instead it's just.
There's a way to do that.
Reloading. I'm in.
Two minutes of sound effects on the podcast.
Right. MV3, baby. The big three.
Why don't we give a little shout out to some friends here or there, Adam?
Yeah, I was really pumped to... That was great. Did you see that maneuver?
I heard it.
I was really pumped to see on our Facebook page, The Flummery. That's a Facebook page, by the way, everybody. Mm-hmm. So we want to thank our friends from Nick and Vince's podcast. It was great to get an offer from veteran podcasters and to join their network. They've got a potpourri of topics going on every week, so please check out Nick and Vince's podcast at buzzsprout.com, buzzsprout.com. You can also find them on Facebook at Nick and Vince Podcast.
Yep.
Oh, I think it's Nick and Vince.
It's just at Nick and Vince.
Yeah, you look up Nick and Vince's podcast, and then it's at Nick
good
and Vince.
Good dudes. I want to thank
you, gentlemen.
They had me on a couple episodes, so it was fun.
Yeah.
I did listen to that. That was one of the first few that I listened to.
Yeah, they were doing movies and music and stuff, too, right? It was good. I liked it.
Well, Steve and I were talking about this for a while, and then we brought in Adam, but like that really got the flame in my butt.
Like
when Nick
number two or nothing.
When Nick and Vince brought me on, that was the time that I was like, all right, we're really going to
do
this.
Launch it.
You did. After that, I was like, you're doing it.
Yeah.
You're on board.
So I was like, where are we going to get the money? Let's go on a robbing spree.
Yeah. That's how we got this public service job.
At PBS?
A robbing spree. And then we have to do this for free for 15 years.
Brought to you this month by Ramsey County.
Hey, Avery Grove Heights police chief. Oh, ooh, too soon. That's not going to pan. That's not going to play
well
nationally.
Did something happen in Germany? Did something happen in Berlin recently?
Yes.
Because
yes.
I just had a friend from that's from the UK say, thanks, we made it back safe. It was fine, but I didn't inquire about it.
Facebook did their, I don't remember what they call it, but it's like I'm okay notifications where they send people in the area apparently a thing that says, hey, are you in this area? Can you let people know, your friends and family know you're okay? And then like my friend Carl Drulo, it was not an earthquake. There were tornadoes in Oklahoma. And they did that, and he sent out, I'm okay, everybody. And everybody's like, oh, my God, I didn't even know there were tornadoes. But they did. Yeah, Facebook did that. That's probably why she was notifying
people. What happened?
Well.
Is what I'm wondering.
They haven't said for sure yet. Terrorists. But there's a truck drove into a crowd of people at a Christmas get-together. You know, an outside Christmas.
Like a festival hobby thing. Festival,
yeah. And just like this.
Big doings.
Yeah, it's like this courtyard. He drives in and he runs over a bunch of people, and there were 9 people dead.
Plenty hurt.
And it was a big truck. And so they're not saying right away, which is good. You know, if it was, they're like, we haven't decided yet if it was an accident or on purpose. But I mean, it's probably legit. It's probably a terrorist thing.
Whatever. I mean, it's huge, but it's not huge.
No. 9 people.
Right. Loss of life sucks.
Yeah. It was just... So I read about that today. I've been reading Canadian news now. Because I'm so sick of...
Ever since Alan Thicke's passing. Giving a little nod to the north.
Right.
He was my hero.
It's all right, man. Don't be afraid.
Everything from Family Matters to How I Met Your Mother.
Whenever you have a dad that has to deal with Boner... You know he's a good dude.
My friend's Facebook. He posts on his Facebook. I'm on a thread right now asking how does Boner feel. There's 26 comments, he says. Oh my
God. And Boner passed away a couple years ago, too.
Yeah. He
was froze to death.
What?
I'm pretty sure it was either drugs and then freezing to death or something like that.
Complications of drugs.
So
was Boner, that what it was?
I don't. That's what they call everything when you get too fucked up and you die of something else. They don't blame it on the drugs. It was a complication of said drugs.
Is that like when you get divorced and they say you have irreconcilable differences?
Are you guys
get me away from her before I blow her fucking head off? I can resolve this real quickly, folks. But no.
Are you guys saying that Boner died of exposure? Is that what's going on? Oh,
nice. Yeah. Well played.
Well, if he was out in yesterday's weather with that thing hanging out, yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, it's brutal. Brutally cold.
Yeah, and then for some reason it's 30 degrees warmer. Still cold.
Yeah, it doesn't feel like it, though.
No.
Someone said, it's 24 degrees warmer today. I'm like, nope, still winter.
You know, like when I was filling up gas the other night when we went to go see Star Wars, that's when it was starting to get cold.
Frigid.
And it was up on the up in SA.
Yeah.
And it's wide open up there.
Yeah. Yep. Wind comes howling.
I saw you drive by, actually.
Did you?
Yeah, and I was filling up, and I was like, this sucks.
You didn't see what I was doing in my car, did you?
No.
He was hoping you were going to pull in and pump gas for him while he sat in the car and jerked off.
It's warm in here.
It's cold outside.
I did see Jason, though. I let my car warm up for longer than you did, which, whatever.
You saw his
size. It's not a competition. But he went out to warm his truck up before closing up, and I went out there. I drove by him. I rolled my window down and go, hey, buddy, where's the nearest hotel? Because he's like one across the street.
It's right across the parking.
Yeah, yeah. He looks up like, what? Oh, hey, what's up? Come in. Come in for last call. I'm like, no, I'm warm now. I'm going home, but.
Yeah, our buddy Saji was like, come in for last call. And I was like, I think we got out of the theater by 1:40, and I'm not going to run up to the bar at 1:40.
Yeah,
tease myself with a beer.
Give me like 7 drinks.
It's last call. Literally, you have to leave in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
She does. You know,
give me 10 shots and a fucking Coors Light.
Line them up.
I can get home before they take effect.
Just as you walk in the door, you collapse. Oh, thank you, Jesus.
Well, the snow was padding if you hit the curbs, so... It's all good.
Yeah.
And then you freeze to death.
Oh, yeah.
Complications of alcoholism.
Of exposure. That's... How many times should I say that?
Die of exposure?
Twice? Is that it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Keep rolling with it, Adam. Yeah.
All right. I'm going to... Until it's dead. Anybody who knows me knows that's what I'm going to do anyway. My friends requested that we talk about undies.
Oh, we kidding. Did that last
I know,
time.
I'm just kidding.
I showed you mine.
That's right, you guys did it.
Yeah, I dropped trowel and showed
no,
it.
No, it was I was sarcasm. We don't want to talk about undies today.
Well, no.
Unless they're panties.
Oh, you know what? I tell you what, though. If you don't mind, I would like to ask you about those highfalutin undies that you're wearing now. You said they're like...
What is highfalutin? Is that like, well, does that mean they're gluten-free
the
underwear?
The Fruit of the Loom PVC X9s or something like that.
Highfalutin.
Like your ball sweat gluten-free. Leaves your body.
Gluten-free. Gluten-free. For all you see, like, no sufferers out there.
X-Temps by Hanes.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. That's what it is.
Dude.
They're worth the price of admission?
They didn't change my whole life. Yeah.
Do they change
my
colors?
My groin's life.
Nice.
So, it's good.
Breathability?
Not on purpose.
No, they didn't change.
Well, I was intrigued because I saw
just
them
in
too.
The middle.
But I was too cheap to spring for them, you know?
How much
they're
are they?
Inexpensive.
Yeah. Oh, you know why I got them?
You got Kohl's cash?
No. My mom. Oh, my God. She's a Kohl's freak. Like, I'm Aldi, Mr. Aldi, and she's Mrs. Kohl's.
Sweet. That's nice.
What was it? It was like one of the, TJ Maxx or Marshalls. Oh. No, it was like Marshalls. I don't go.
Okay.
I don't go to TJ Maxx. Fuck that.
I don't even think they're around anymore.
They have a couple that I know of. Yeah, but I got them on sale. The package was open, so I was a little leery.
they were already worn and tried out.
Chew hole in the leg.
I don't wear other people's dirty underwear, but $20 is $20. You know what I'm saying?
When inches
well, you know
is just
what?
Not enough.
I will invest in some next time, and then I'll give you all my.
So, is it a chafing thing? Is it a breathability
thing?
It's
a breathability, right?
It's a support wicking thing. Yeah. It keeps. How do I say
can you this? Model that for
I
us?
I
want right
to say
now?
It the way I want to say it. Keeps your funk. It pushes your funk out. Your funk can dry.
You said something in the broadcast. Something about the funk.
Your greasy bits can degrease a little.
Your bum can breathe.
What was it?
Do you have that problem when it's -22 out?
If I'm running or something.
I mean, I had burritos the night before.
Yeah, where's our local bad burrito joint? We should plug that next. That's come up a couple times.
You can be plugging your own ass.
Ooh.
Oh, speaking of which, I did go to El Burrito Mercado and picked up some tamales.
Is that good? Is that the one on Conk?
Yeah. El or Cesar Chavez.
Cesar Chavez Bolivar. Yes.
You got some pre-made tamales?
Yeah, they're fantastic.
Sounds awesome.
They're good. Do they come in the corn husks too?
Well, absolutely.
Yeah.
They got the green chicken and the red chili. Then they got
green
a couple
chicken.
Other, it's like chicken and green sauce.
Oh, so like a verde.
Right.
Yeah.
That's good.
And it's,
verde
tasty.
Means green, you guys.
Perfect.
Another translation. Another
Captain Navias. Here again.
Here for another Flummery.
What does pollo mean?
Translation.
Pollo
El pollo is chicken, if you remember from last weekend. This week we have verde. It's green.
What's the Spanish word of the week?
I get it confused. People get it confused. Like, what's the one for truth? It's verdad. So, come on, man. We got to keep people legit here.
I like saying vamonos, too.
That's good. I say vamonos. That means let's go.
Move it.
We got to, you know, we got to save it. It's like one word a week.
Yeah, vamonos. No, today's
verde.
This week is verde.
Verde.
That means green. As in my card in my pants. I can be here. In my green pants. My verde trousers.
I keep bumping
you. You have green trousers?
Yes. Mr. Green Jeans.
How much did you guys ever see the Jimmy Fallon bit with Jennifer Lopez? Got my tight pants on.
No.
I don't think so.
Was it like a song he did?
Yeah. Everybody knows I've got my tight pants on. Dun, dun. And he does his fucking dance. Oh, you got to look it up. I love it. YouTube.
Can we show that on our podcast?
Yes. That'd be awesome. And then Lopez comes out and shuts his ass down. She's like, these are my fucking tight pants. This is my tight pant town.
Yeah.
Honey, hush.
It's awesome. You got to see it. You got to look it up.
Speaking of podcasts.
Flutube that.
You guys watch Joe Rogan or listen to him at all? You know who he just had on?
Mm-mm.
I thought it was really cool. I had James Hetfield on.
Oh, sweet. Nice.
That was pretty sweet, actually. And he, I never knew about it, but James Hetfield's a big beekeeper.
I read something about that.
He was his family, his dad and his parents like raised him doing that.
Yeah.
And now he's doing it with his kids and stuff. I think that's pretty neat, actually.
Really? Yeah. Beekeeper.
Yeah. Getting honey, raising, you know, whatever you do with bees.
Hives, yeah.
Well, yeah, I knew a guy that sold bees. He'd get a truckload every year, and then he would be like the distributor.
Yeah.
He ended up retiring from industrial construction company or maintenance company, maintenance and construction, and who works with my company that I work for. But anyway, he retired. He's doing that full time. Like,
so he's making a living off of it.
Lucrative, yes, it's lucrative.
Where is that at?
I don't remember his what town he lives in or whatever.
So he's doing it in Minnesota here?
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. What do you do with the bees in the winter?
Keep them warm.
Do they?
Or semi-warm.
Is there like you put them in like
slow
a...
slow down and...
Well, they die, right? And then the new ones come out.
Well, I'm sure there's a way that they, like in Minnesota winters, that there's a way that they either hibernate or something's left and then they start anew.
But yeah, the honeycomb is like...
I'm not learned on it.
Isn't the honeycomb, awful? They lay eggs in there. The queen lays a bunch of eggs in the honeycomb, right? And
we need a bee specialist to call
I'm
right
telling
now.
You what, that's what happens. I'm 75% sure that's correct. We could.
Do they all die, though?
Call somebody now.
Right now. We'll get that eventually. Make a phone call somebody up.
Yeah, because I was wondering, too, you know, do they, because some of them migrate, right?
Wasn't
do
they?
That part of the big concern of the Mexican killer bees because yeah. they're migrating they up migrate, through Tejas.
Right. Tejas, is that like right. is that like another word for boobies?
Yes. Long cylindrical boobies. Hence the J.
Look at her Tejas.
Look at her Tejas.
Tejas and tassels this weekend, Mr.
Brownstone. Along with waffles.
Did you say Mr. Brownstone?
Yeah.
All right. Guns N' Roses like is coming to town next year.
And, oh, yeah. Okay, I got you there.
Who's opening up for them? Nickelback?
Oh,
I hope so.
Fuck you. Don't ever compare those two.
And Bon Jovi.
I didn't compare them. I'm just saying there's no comparison. I'm just asking who's opening up for them.
Why would Nickelback open up for anybody? Didn't they die?
No, they're still alive.
Fuck.
Chad Kroeger's still a thing.
Is he famous still?
Yeah, in Canada.
Well, I mean, I guess.
There's, you know what? Whatever. As much as I make fun of him and don't really care
they
for him,
it.
Three quarters of the population out there love Nickelback.
Three quarters, you think?
A good half.
Well, then why do they get made fun of so much if they were that awesome?
I don't know. What is it about Nickelback that just people don't like? What is it?
How does their sound?
Well, wasn't it the fact that he... like corrected his teeth and got all pretty when he started becoming a rock star.
Well, he did have a nose too. Did
right.
You know
yeah.
He had
nose
a
really?
Chad's got a crop.
Nasty
he's got a
hair
schnoz.
And he had bad teeth and something else. And
what is he? Is he from the UK or what?
He's Canadian, right?
Is that Canada,
okay.
Man.
I'm joking with the teeth thing.
Like Quebec.
Yeah.
Are you from Quebec?
He's from Canada, but he's got British teeth.
I like this. We're talking. Let's talk about Nickelback.
I don't want to do a whole
really?
Lot.
I just want to know what the... There's such a
why?
Night and day variety of...
Oh, and I'm sorry. The whole bee thing?
Okay, let's hear the bee thing.
They
and we'll
actually,
come back to that.
They store up the honey that they eat, they consume to keep their energy to stay warm. And
really?
So they just stay right in the hive and don't do nothing.
So they don't die?
Nope. Okay. Nope. They get DirecTV and they just chill out. NFL ticket, you know.
Listen to Buzzin' Country. On-
something. Something. Yeah, a little hoedown.
You know
down.
What they did this week? This last week?
What?
I think it was like TBS or whatever. They're obviously watching the Star Wars trilogies because they're
playing
the back to back.
Yep.
I was at awesome. The gym. I've been at the gym every time I look up. There's freaking Star Wars on when I'm on the treadmill.
You talk about the gym more than CrossFit. People talk about CrossFit.
I'm sorry.
I'm just kidding. Don't get down. Keep doing it.
Down, boy. Down.
It's a joke, man. It's all good.
Yeah, I'm just saying that's
good
where I
you.
Noticed it.
Yeah.
It really has nothing to do with the gym, but I'm just saying it's on.
Yeah. Well, because they got all the screens and stuff on. So, yeah, they were running them actually in chronological order and just kept running. Kept
four
looping.
Through six through one through three?
Yeah. It was nice.
Did you get on that train?
And, you know, I got the whole kit and caboodle on the Blu-ray and stuff, so I don't.
See, you know what's funny is, like, when Phantom Menace came out, it was 99, and that was the last VHS I ever bought.
Is that right?
Yeah.
So meet me.
I don't know why this is happening.
That's all right. I made more noise than it did.
The last one. And then, 99 Phantom Menace came out, and it was the last VHS to come out. And then right after that, seriously? It was DVD.
Wow. That's a collector's piece, dude.
It was. It is, and I still have it.
You know, you were talking about some artwork. I've got some conceptual artwork from that movie series. Because it's got Darth Maul in it. And,
yeah.
And I can't remember. It was some Chinese dude that did it. So they're not like worth a ton of money, but one day they might be. They're in like That's a cool. chrome container.
Oh, I know who you're I know who there's a Chen, Asian artist. Yeah, Chen. He was the main he was the head like conceptual designer. Yeah. I remember
so these are
I actually watched a video on, you know, how like the making
yeah,
of
exactly. That's yeah. And they're almost as big as this table. You know, they're what, 17 inches.
Yeah, so they're like prints.
Kind of like a litho or something yeah. to that effect. So
like a 1 out of
yes.
300 or right. whatever.
Yep.
Yeah.
And of course, they sat in a wet basement, so the one's kind of nasty.
Are you going to eBay that shit?
I already tried. They're really not worth much.
Oh.
And then my nephew / godson was into the Star Wars thing, and so I was like, oh, yeah, you know, maybe like these are kind of like, because it's conceptual. You yeah. know, it's not like an yeah. actual nice, clean, tidy thing.
You can see like pencil marks and whatever.
Yeah, it's like, oh, that doesn't really look like him. It's like, well, it was a concept art piece, you right. know?
Yeah, probably cooler than just a picture of him.
Yeah.
Was he wanted a poster of him or something?
Well, I think he was thinking more of like movie poster style.
Yeah, okay.
You know,
okay, yeah.
Glossy and, yep. you know, it has a message.
I would love that.
Yeah.
It's cool.
Yeah. I'll just tell you what, I'm drinking a message out of the bottle right now.
It says drink more.
There was no police reference there at all.
Oh.
Sending out an SOS.
Love that. I love the police. Mm. I love Sting, too.
Oh, and everybody, every time you talk about the police, I'm gonna say, oh, did you know the guy that once I was a stalker? Ah, it's like the biggest fact people know about the police.
Oh, it's every God. Breath you take. Oh,
shut up.
Yeah.
Everybody knows that.
Yeah.
The one thing people have to...
I would go see Sting in a heartbeat. And I would even go see the police if they made a reunion.
Absolutely. I bought a couple of Sting's, you know, solo efforts. It was
10 Sumner's Gold is one of my favorites.
It was just, you know, they're a little slower and stuff, but yeah, for me at the time it was good.
I play heavy music and I listen to heavy music, but I like slow stuff still. I mean, you can't just sit there and sugar it up all the time, you know. Throw in some fucking Coldplay once in a while.
Nickelback, yeah,
what? Well, that's.
No, I'm sorry.
I've actually seen Nickelback live.
What did you think? Well, no wonder you're defending them.
The reason I went is because when Jerry Cantrell did his solo stuff, he opened up for him, so I had to go to that because I'm not going to miss Jerry Cantrell.
True. Right on, dude.
True.
That's pretty awesome, though. A friend of mine really was into Jerry Cantrell, too. Andy. Oh, speaking of that friend, he gave me these headphones. They're his headphones from when he was on air on 93X.
Oh, really?
Very nice.
Yeah.
So we have some
literally his, like, yeah, I've got radio memorabilia on my lid right now. So that was really cool of him. I thought
we need dick headphones next.
Like, well, bachelorette party, that's everybody not put on your work. Dick caps.
Why? All you can hear is...
Old One Eye's acting up again.
Hey, give me your headphones. Oh, my God. Safe for work. I'm sorry I talked over your sound.
Make sure you guys blur that part if you're listening to this.
That last sound effect was good. Beep, beep, beep.
The One-Eyed Trouncer. It's okay. It's okay. Adam, you going to poop?
He's gonna go touch himself.
It's beer dog.
It's beer dog. It's
beer dog.
Beer 30.
It is beer
30. Yep. So
beer 78. I don't know what that means.
Yep. Almost take a break and take a sip. That's what it comes down to.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Everybody do
that. We got to time that out. So there's always somebody talking while somebody's sipping.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're out there listening, take a drink with us.
Yes. Right, yep. And here's your cue. 2, 1, drink.
Ready? Everybody go. Oh, so good.
That's better than a moment of silence.
Right? Oh, that was... There we go. Nice.
I don't even think we need to talk. We just need to sit and stare at each other and drink beer.
Then it gets weird. Then it sounds like a soundtrack to whatever.
The Star Wars.
Becca De Mornay's film that she did.
Oh, yes.
Yum.
She was a hot little cookie back in the day.
No, yeah. Another one who got famous was Sasha Grey. She did.
Mm. She's not that famous.
Well, I mean, Entourage was
I know who you're talking about.
She was in like four Entourage episodes.
Yeah. Hmm. She, like I said, she made appearances. Yeah. But like Risky Business Green was Year's a pretty Dark. Big movie when it came out. And she,
oh, okay. Yeah. I don't really know who Rebecca De Mornay is. Did I make that clear yet?
No. Did I? You ever see Risky Business?
I did, but one of my least
The
favorite.
One he does on the train? She's like, I've always wanted to do it in a train.
On the subway.
On the subway.
All right.
Well you're going to go home and watch that and wank the wick. Yeah. Right?
Oh, no wonder. She was cast as a prostitute, right?
Right.
Yep.
Well, that makes
sense. So it
sense.
Made sense. Ding, ding, ding. Right? What happened to Julie Roberts in Pretty Woman? She was.
Wasn't a prostitute.
She was in the movie.
Well, right, yes. But not.
And then she actually became a prostitute in real life.
Afterwards, now she loved sucking dick.
Just hoeing it up. How's that iPhone treating you there, Adam?
Oh,
don't worry about it.
I'm serious.
I know it's.
I don't hear it, so.
Okay. Yeah.
It's all good.
They will hear it, and they will tell us.
Rebecca De Mornay's father. What the hell was his name? Real, real fanatical Christian Bible thumper.
I didn't know that.
That makes sense.
Well, that makes total sense.
Yeah, he was on...
He'd either be a police chief or like a crazy pastor or something.
Yeah, crazy was...
So he got some TV time or some publicity somehow?
Worked it. He worked that angle.
Really?
Yep.
Is he one of those losers?
Did he
who's like I can cure
pretty much? Yeah.
So he was that fanatical. Was he that fanatical where he might have touched his daughter at some point in her early years?
Those are always. That is a great question. Me and Buddy at Work have talked about this many times.
I gotta look her up.
Those
yeah,
people,
look
the
that
guys
up.
Who are like, I hate homosexuals. Well, they don't say that. They're like, I hate gays. And it's like, well, get it right if you really want to make a point. But whatever. I hate homosexuals. I hate, and we can cure you and. You know, the guys who are always like, God hates you, and like the worst of the worst,
right.
They're so outspoken and try and get everybody to think the way they're thinking, are always like, it always ends up, they get caught. Like the one dude got caught in France.
Perfect example of a movie of that. I can give it to you right now.
The guy who got caught?
No, yeah, go ahead. I'll let you finish, and then I'll tell you my side of it.
Okay. Well, I'm almost, remember the guy who got caught in France with a escort, male escort. He's like, no, I just hired him to carry my bags around. And he was like...
I was like Eddie Murphy, too.
Well, I don't... But Eddie Murphy, that's beside... Like, the point is that the guys who are the most fanatical, I think the reason they are is just because they, like, hate that part about themselves or something.
Yeah, that's always is.
They always turn out to be gay or, you know...
Why do you think the guys that always start fights... Yeah. The guys that always start fights are the most insecure guys out there.
Yeah.
Right. Well, what's the movie?
Methinks he
doesn't. The perfect example for that, what you're referring to, is American Beauty.
Mm. Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah.
The father.
Yep.
Not Kevin Spacey, but the father, the kid's father in that.
Every time. Well, I've only seen that scene probably two or three times. Right.
It's a good movie.
It is a good movie, and.
And I would totally do Mina Survey or whatever her name is in there.
Every time he like goes in for a smooch sesh with Kevin Spacey, this is what I do to
when
myself.
When the dad does that to Kevin Spacey.
Yeah, this is what I do to myself when I'm watching. I hear this. The quote from when Joe Namath was wasted. Thank you, Steve. When Joe Namath was wasted, he was like, I want to kiss you.
Yeah. With the news reporter or whatever.
Yeah, and that the
Aaron
blonde
Andrews
woman.
Or whatever.
Yes, yes. Yeah, the one who unfortunately had to go through that.
All right, Steve, did you find something?
Yeah, Wally George.
Is that De Mornay's dad?
Yeah.
Okay.
What's his deal? Give us a little rundown on that.
Great. Wally George was an American conservative. Fucking
glasses, Steve. We're young. We need glasses.
Well, sorry,
what are these days?
Did you almost freeze up and hit the floor, Steve?
No, because I couldn't see nothing.
He had to get his glasses on.
Yeah, right. So Wally George was an American conservative radio and television commentator, calling himself the father of combat TV.
What does that mean?
He was a fixture on Southern California television for three decades as the host of The Wally George Show.
That's a real thing.
Hi, everybody. I'm Wally George.
And that's Rebecca De Mornay's dad.
Yeah.
Wow. That explains I had no idea.
Why she was kind of messed up.
I had no idea. Do you remember what she looks like, Adam?
Yeah, it came back to me when you talked about the train scene. But I remember her more like in the house with the egg and stuff, the Fabergé egg.
She was pretty hot in the day.
Yeah, she still is.
Oh,
she
the hand that rocks the cradle too. That was
she was in that. That was another. Ooh, creepy. That was like mid late 80s.
That movie freaked me out. I shouldn't have watched that movie. I was like 14 or something. Not even.
you're still 14.
Yeah, we've talked about this. That's my thing.
You're just a 14-year-old boy.
Hey guys, my Legos.
I got my first boner last year.
Finally put away. Finally alphabetized all my football.
She still looks pretty good.
Playing cards.
Yes.
I guess who I didn't do that when I was.
I wish I could show you this on the podcast.
The broadcast.
Well, you can look it up yourself.
Yeah.
Tom Cruise is still looking good too. I know Scuba Steve loves.
Fuck that. Tom Cruise.
Right.
You guys want to talk Scientology?
Oh fuck. Are you a Scientologist?
Steve goes every week. Steve gives 3/4 of his money to Scientology.
Those guys.
And Tom Cruise and his character Jack Reacharound.
Jack Reacharound.
So they're redoing The Mummy, and he's in that now.
Oh, come on.
I don't know
Tom
if it's
Cruise
a redo.
Is in The Mummy.
Yeah, he had like 4 eyes.
Why is Tom Cruise in The Mummy?
It's a new B movie. It's a new version of The Mummy.
That's what we needed, is another Mummy.
Okay, if you were him, would you do that movie? With your background, would you do The Mummy? I wouldn't do The Mummy. Maybe I'd do Independence Day 2.5.
So was Brendan Fraser busy or what?
I don't know. The only movie that I liked him in was Encino Man.
You like, really?
I love Pauly Shore's in there.
Mm-hmm. I liked it when he was like the devil was messing with him. That super hot. Oh, what's her name?
Bedazzled.
Starts with an H. She was married to one of the Bonds. This is how I remember names.
Was that a movie he was in?
Oh, yeah, he was in a movie.
She was big with Hugh Grant.
Hugh Grant. Yeah, she was married
Elizabeth
Hugh
Hurley.
Thank you.
Yep. There we go. We did it, you guys.
Nice. Who is together. When she did, well, I heard she's older. She's a lot older. Like when she did Austin Powers movies, she was only like 40 or early 40s at that point. Yeah. But she's smoking hot. She was smoking hot for her age.
She's always been good looking.
I'm a brunette guy.
Ditto. Thanks, dude.
Whew. Nice. Cheers.
Sorry, you get all the blondes.
Yeah.
Well, my past with dating women, I've always been more attracted to brunettes, but somehow I always end up with a fucking blonde. Yeah. That's the way it works.
There are some great.
Because you eventually want to get laid, right?
Enough of this talky.
With the lights off, y'all.
Yeah, I don't know what it is. Is that a thing with everybody? Like, they're like, oh, I love brunettes, but I ended up with a blonde.
No, that's
I'm not even ragging on blondes here. I'm just, that's how it worked for me.
That's your thing.
That's my thing.
That's cool.
Your thing.
You know? Blondes in my life.
Never brunette, always a blonde.
But I will tell you, I did have one uber crazy brunette, and she was part Latino.
I mean, that happens. Yeah, that happens.
Brown eyes.
Yep, it's funny. You can't really classify. People always say, "Oh, this one type of person was this, and this one type of person." There's all types. It's funny.
I'm not putting a finger on anyone that's worse or whatever or better. I'm just saying, like, there's.
We're not trying to finger specific ladies here.
I'm trying to finger specific ladies. I don't know what you're talking about.
You're the one that said you didn't want to put your finger on it. Like,
Dicky. That was the joke. Thanks, guys.
So let's, in your future here, I'd like to have some guests on, and whether we call them up or set that up. Can you guys give me a few people that you might be interested in talking to? I talked to a couple of guys from B-52s, and they said they'd be interested in coming up.
That's a definite.
Maybe we could talk a little bit shop with service industry or whatnot.
That would be awesome. There's 2 people from 52s we talked to, right? And then, it's funny. I got a couple of friends from work and a couple of friends from Frandom that are interested too. I got like 4 people that would. I don't know what we would do with my work friends. I'm trying to get them into telling stories.
I think we should, you know.
Not about work.
It needs to be somebody that it would have something interesting to say.
Right. Obviously. No, these guys, that's why I talk to them. They're like the people I talk to, you know what I mean? Like,
I say we just go to like a institution and get somebody that doesn't talk. And just prop them up in front of a mic. Here we go.
We got a podcast.
Sam Harry over there. He's bouncing his head off.
Speaking to this.
Is he still breathing?
Sign language translator.
We'll figure that out. We'll move on with that.
What do you think? Have you talked to anybody yet, or are you just still kind of feeling it out?
Mostly feeling it out. Spoke with the one guy at work that's got the band.
Oh, cool.
Because I told him I told him about the Flummery and the page finally being up, and we're finally starting our thing here, get the ball rolling.
What do you want to say the band name, or does he want you to, or do you know? Why not? Right?
You fucker! I knew you were gonna say that.
You don't.
I
can't don't have the to.
Band's name.
Oh, fuck, I'm sorry. He's gonna kill you.
I'm sorry, Marty. Honestly, we'll give you guys some better props. Why I'm forgetting what his band name is, because he also gave me a couple. He's got some buddies that do podcasts as well, and so he gave me those titles. Something realm of something or other and whatnot. So I've got all that ringing in my head, so I can't. But they're playing February 3rd at the Underground
Club. Underground.
Yep.
Where?
That's in Minneapolis.
Yeah.
It's like a.
It is. The ceiling is low, right?
Kind of.
I saw me and my.
What's the bar
the
that it's connected to upstairs? There's a bar upstairs.
Are you talking about? It's not like Mario's.
But the bar upstairs is a separate name.
Right.
Well,
I can't remember. So anyways, I'll get all that information together because Marty said he'd love to come on and talk Muzak and all that jazz.
Yeah. Are they a cover band, or they do their own original stuff?
No, they do all their own original stuff.
What kind of stuff? What are they doing?
Heavy metal stuff like Lance does. Jamming.
Am I heavy metal?
Yeah. No, actually, you know what? You've come way back. You started out heavier than you are now. Yeah.
You're a melodic metal guy.
Yeah, I would go with melodic metal.
I think that's pretty cool. It's a good way to go because I have a real hard time just like.
Oh, like the After the Burial stuff that I was playing when you guys got in here?
No, I mean, I have that on my. I do still listen to that stuff, but it's only. I do like two or three songs. And then I moved
back.
That's
for when you masturbate, right?
Right. Mm. How do you know all this stuff? So then I
watch you.
He does the same thing.
I do the same thing.
His songs are a little longer than yours, but that's all
right. Is it the Underground Music Cafe?
No.
No, it's the same
thing. I think it's Club Underground.
Yeah, I believe Club Underground.
Minneapolis. I'm looking it up.
For the type of music that Steve's talking about that he plays, he'd play Club Underground.
Club Underground, Northeast. Oh, it is in Northeast.
Yeah, there's a bar above it, though, because it's a basement. It's a basement club.
Yeah. At the Spring Street Tavern.
There you go.
That's it.
Thank you.
It's on Spring Street.
I figured that out in my brain.
Have you been there before?
I have been there once. I shit you not. Okay, that's hilarious that this came up, because me and my wife, she remembers this. We talk about it at least once a year, I would say. We've talked about it, 15 times.
Six.
So, no, we're still talking about the club here. And then
I was too.
Oh, yeah, the bathroom. Okay.
Club sex.
So, so we went to this place and we saw some cool, it was like amateur night, right? But there were a couple of good bands, very different. But I was just like, okay, I see what they're doing there. Fuck it, that's cool. And then there was this band that somehow came all the way from Baltimore, Maryland.
Oof.
And the one sits down. She looks like a 20-year-old Yoko Ono. She sits down.
So she's Asian.
Yep. She sits down and legs crossed. And she's got one of those little pianos, like a key. Mm. Oh, what the hell is it called?
MIDI?
It's got like 12 keys.
A little MIDI.
Is it a MIDI?
And it's got like effects and stuff. Yep. A MIDI?
It's a MIDI keyboard.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, a MIDI keyboard. And she's just like, I'm like, is that Ross from Friends? But then the rest of the band gets in there. I don't even remember what they sound like. I just remember one of them standing on a chair, but the ceiling is so low that his head is arched.
Yeah, that
like
stage,
this.
Your stage is like.
And then they're like, and they really get in there. It's like, wow, wow, wah, 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 wah. And they're like throwing water on each other. It's the worst performance I've ever seen.
So it was like
seen.
Performance art
yeah,
music?
Say performance
no,
art.
No, it was not. I don't think that's what they were trying to do. I think they were really fucked up.
Oh, they're rolling on E?
It's possible it was they were trying
from,
to be artful.
They're the ones from Maryland?
They're from Maryland. Then
you know they're fucked
I'll go check that show out with you, Steve, if you want to go check out your buddy Marty's band. I'm like, yeah. I'm down about supporting
bands.
What
day of the week is that?
It's, and I hate to even say it, but it's like the band name's like, not Procrastinator, but it's got an ater on the end of it.
The Masturbator.
Pro-Masturbator.
Masturbator.
It's gonna. I'm getting really close. It'll come to me.
Yeah, is it gonna fall off and hit you in the forehead?
Shit.
Little tawny ton ton.
Yeah. No, nice guy though. Sounds like he hangs with some nice people.
If you find out his band name, I might know them because I'm surrounded by like.
I told you the name, and you said that you recognized them from some other thing.
I think I remember the conversation, but I don't remember the band name.
Oh boy.
So
you're of no help.
What did you think of Gojira? Which they're not new, but you've seen them?
I saw them live at First Avenue. A couple years ago, I was with my buddy Dana Allen and another buddy of his, and it was
cool.
Gojira's amazing.
I thought they're amazing. Really cool. I just discovered them, obviously. But.
Yeah, they're a French metal band.
That's pretty good.
Yeah, we went to First Avenue to see them, and it was, I've never seen First Avenue so packed. Like, you know where the stairs go up on each side?
Yeah.
Like, I had to sit and stand on those stairs because that's how packed it was.
Wow.
So for First Avenue, I mean, it's a nice mid-size venue.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
It's not like, I would say the like myth is a little bit larger than that. But
like 1,500 people in there?
Yeah. I mean, but First Avenue was packed when I saw them, and it was, cool. It was a great show.
I mean,
show.
They deserve it. I think they're, yeah. I loved it. That's my favorite new metal. Right.
They got some cool chops, and it gets kind of ambient once in a while. So, you know, it gets kind of toolish, you know, a little bit.
But it's like, also.
But it's still heavy, and it's like, rah.
It's not gimmicky.
No.
It's just, you can tell they're just doing.
Aren't they coming back soon?
It's like, I don't know. I haven't looked them up, but I'd love to see them. I just have really gotten into that. And I'm surprised because I haven't looked up a lot of new music lately, but the new music I've been finding,
you know,
is
what that, you
like
know what
metal.
Gojira means, right?
No, and that was, I was going to say. I thought it was like.
Japanese.
It's Japanese for Godzilla.
Okay, well, good. Then I was right. So I was going to ask. I was like, oh, they're French. So I wonder what Gojira means.
Yeah, no, it's
in
actually
France.
A Japanese.
Gojira.
Gojira. You know, oh my God, it's Gojira.
Gojira. Run.
Yeah, so if they come into town, which I think I saw something about that, well, you should try to go to that.
Go, go, Gojira.
Do, do, do.
Other bands in town. Obviously, we got Guns N' Roses coming next year.
I want to go to that so bad because
I don't know if I'm ready to sprout on those tickets.
I have had so many awesome bands that I've liked in my life from that era that I never went to see. Like, one of my favorite bands of all time is AC/DC. Didn't go to the last concert.
Since I'm a metalhead, January 15th, which is a Sunday, Protest the Hero, which is a Canadian band.
Sundays.
Is coming.
I'll do that.
Another one is our Hometown Heroes After the Burial will be here Saturday, February 25th, and I will definitely, and they're headlining.
I thought that was a Sunday.
They will be headlining. No, it is the 25th, or I think it's the 26th.
It's a Sunday, though, right?
It's the 26th. And they will be headlining that show.
And you get them to let you play.
Yeah.
That'd be so hilarious. That'd be awesome. Not hilarious, awesome.
Awesomely hilarious.
Oh, and then in April, I think me and, we talked about this. We'll be going to Chicago. Are you going to be doing that with us?
About to broach that one with the wife.
Yeah, so we're thinking of Chicago, April 7th through the 10th, which will be driving out on Friday the 7th because they're not coming here because that's how Minnesota works here sometimes.
Yeah.
We're always the, like... What is it with concerts and people not making that
get some pretty good shit.
We do, but like I feel like if there's a band on tour, like 50-60% of those bands don't hit Minnesota.
No.
Yeah.
It's always they're always going to go to Chicago.
Yep.
Right?
Yep.
You know they're going to go to like Omaha.
Well, there was a time,
you know,
right?
They're going to go to Milwaukee. They're going to go to Omaha and Milwaukee.
And then
the big ones come through here because we've got XL. When XL Energy came, it was just nonstop awesome shows from the big bands, the big groups. And now I think we'll have the same thing with US Bank Stadium. But like you're talking about, the mid-level guys who are like the good one, you know, the stuff you really want to see because you're going to see them in a better venue, you know?
Yeah. I'm more about that than any.
More Chicago.
Than anything. Like, Scuba, what do we go do? We went to see Rival Sons.
Rival Sons.
They're on, I think they're on Northern Invasion this year.
Cool.
Yeah.
You know?
I'm still kicking myself about Northern Invasion. I'm mad. I didn't see freaking, I've seen Metallica before, so I'm glad. And I probably, a band I'll usually only want to see once, like the big bands, the good, you know, the most popular ones. But I really wanted to see Volbeat and... Yeah, like I only see them ever.
That's ever. So they were here 2 years. They were here 2 years ago when Jason's band Cold Kingdom played.
Yeah, I wanted.
And to I was see. On stage backstage.
I want to see Volbeat so bad, and I wanted to see another one. Well, now I just brain farted it, just like last week. What? Who was with Metallica and Volbeat? It was
when
the most recent show at US Bank.
Oh, there was another one.
Yeah, it was. It's Jordan's like. Like one of his favorite bands.
Let me look that up real quick here.
Their song "Hail to the King," Avenged Sevenfold. Thank you.
Oh Avenged yeah, it was Avenged
Sevenfold. Yeah. Avenged.
How do you guys feel? Sevenfold. Do you ever listen to Avenged Sevenfold, Scuba?
I do not.
Mm. I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love it.
They're kind of the epitome of the new rock metal band. You know.
They do it right. They do.
They've
it
been
well.
Around for a little while now
well,
too.
It's like it them and familiar. Volbeat are obviously influenced by Metallica. Like they want to be Metallica, obviously, right?
What's the band you were talking about?
Volbeat and Volbeat?
The guy's got a really deep voice.
Well, the guy, the Finnish guy, Volbeat, he was so famous in Finland. Like I read up.
Is he a Finnish guy?
Yeah.
He's the singer?
Yep. Well, the whole band I think is Finnish, but at least that's where they do their work. And he was huge there, won a bunch of like best musician in Finland type stuff, right?
Oh, really?
And then they moved on and got national, and he did it. I mean, they did it. They're good enough to do it. I love it.
Well, they're on huge tours, so.
Yeah, absolutely. Volbeat's really a great band, I think. Yeah. And then, same thing, Avenged Sevenfold, they do sound a lot different than Metallica in certain ways, but you can tell that they want to be the arena rock band. Like, who yeah, doesn't? When you do that type of music, that's what you want.
It's arena rock.
Yeah, that's what you want.
It's running
thin as far as acts go. People don't seem to be doing that much anymore.
Right.
You know, the full-on rock show.
I had a thought.
Congratulations.
Just the one.
Bing!
I had one thought. But it's like with technology and how everything's going, and I hate repeating this stuff, but it's like people's attention spans and going to like shows and stuff. It's just a different era, man. Right. It's tough. It's a really tough thing to be a musician.
Why don't you... I didn't know for sure if you wanted to talk about it or not, so I didn't ask you last week, but why don't you tell us a little bit about your band?
Mm.
In your experience.
Do you have to get a permission
slip
first?
You don't want to do it?
Well,
I met all the guys. They're great.
Yeah.
There's a chick,
and,
too.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Well, okay. My singer is a female singer.
Yeah.
Yeah. And yeah. Live?
We've had one show, and it's been a rough kind of start right now. It's towards the end of the year and everybody's got these shows planned out. So I think, you know, everybody's who's already in bands in the local scene have had their end of year kind of planned out already. So, you know, we did that one show. It was the end of September, October or whatever it was. I forget what it was. And we really haven't had any luck. But I think right now it's, for me with the band, it's, finding the next step. And now we're talking about actually, well, the band's talking about trying to get in the studio and maybe doing a couple tracks and getting them done while we're waiting to play live again. So,
and you can distribute that to places, you know, that are looking for bands. And
I'm thinking about, we released a single called "Ride on Titan," and I kind of want to make that more radio friendly and redo it. So I would cut out part of the song, but that's just my thought on it. And you know, that comes down to us sitting down and talking and figuring it out. But like, hopefully, but you know, with 2017 coming around, we'll be starting to play more shows and figuring it out. But towards the end of the year, a lot of the venues and bands are all filled up and people have ideas. And we had a few offers, but like when you're in a band with five people, not everybody can be on board at the same time.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's hard to get everybody in on the same gig at the same time.
Our other guitar player, Kevin, is going to school to be an engineer right now. So
ooh, yeah, that's a big one.
Yeah, that's his number one thing, you know.
There's so money in engineering, silly boy.
What's wrong with him? Grab that guitar.
Yeah.
Fucking skip, school.
You'd be in China.
So. You'd be big in China.
Huge. So, what's the name of the band you're in again?
I forget.
You know, really, are you?
The name of the band is Eris, E-R-I-S.
And Ride on Titan, you can find that on YouTube.
You can find that on any digital.
Facebook.
You can find it on iTunes. You can find it on Spotify. You can find it anywhere. It's out there.
Right on.
It sounds good. You should check it out. It's a good little video on YouTube.
Oh, we could get like your permission to play the whole thing, couldn't we?
For free, dude. Free.
You can listen to it through your
speakers.
Your earballs.
Speakers.
I could tell you. I'm like, I'm doing it. I don't care what you
whatever. Think. Whatever. Well, you know, there'll be a time and a place where I want to talk about it more. But
right on.
I'm just not feeling it today. Not feeling it. It's okay. Should be. My whole thing is like, I've been kind of in this disarray, and like I feel like, you know, like when we're at the standstill right now, it's like, what's the next step?
Drive you nuts. Well, you were working so hard up to this point.
Yeah, and then, you know, we play that first show, and they're like, oh, you know, shit's going to start falling in place, and then nothing's happened. And it's not because we can't do it. It's just, like, certain things and attributes and things that happen, you know, it's just...
So, not to dig, but are people getting a little disheartened by the process?
I would say me out of the most right now.
Well, you've been the biggest driver, though, so, I mean, it's...
I'm looking for more drive out of other members in the band. You know, like, you know, I don't want to say that I've been the guy that's pulling the chains, but I've been pulling the chains. You know, it's like, I know I want a little bit back. I want a little bit back. Sure. You know, I want I want somebody to inspire me a little bit.
Well, it's good practice for you for when you get big. You guys held the room. When I was I was at the show.
I saw a video of it, and people's heads were bobbing. Yeah. I was pretty happy about that.
Held the room. Everybody was cheering for you, just like more than the other bands that were on there. And I think you just keep your head up. It's going to be... I still love the project, so I think you're going to be fine. Once, like I said with us, it's like once the holidays, you get a good two and a half months where you can really get into a rhythm there, you know?
Yep. Yeah, and it's, you know... The weather and, you know, the end of the year and everybody got, you know, it's just, it's, I don't know, it all falls down on you. Suck.
Vikings. That is correct.
So, what was I going to say about the band?
I don't know.
I need to stop switching strings on my guitars because now I'm introducing six string songs back into the band and they're like, just stick with 7 and 8. We got this new Telecaster here, and I love the shit out of it.
Cool.
It's kind of inspired me to play. So, whatever inspires me, I don't care. I just need to do it, and whether it be sticking a plug in my butt, or
a butt plug,
or you know, like playing a chord, you know, whether it be sexual or musical or whatever, you know,
existential.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't look over here. I've got nothing.
Steve, you still playing your drums?
Yeah, infrequently. Not nearly as much as I'd like to.
Steve's got a nice drum set.
You know, it scares the dog.
Yeah.
You know, I have to do it kind of when the wife's not around. Guns don't bother her, but she doesn't like the bass and shit. When I start thumping and wailing on it, she runs way downstairs and chills out, but tough shit. She'll get over it.
She'll get used to it.
Yeah. But no, I don't play them nearly enough. Yeah, you can only have so much fun putting the headphones on and trying to play along with shit and goof around with different things and sounds and whatnot. So, but I was looking at buying a cajon.
Is that like a thing to cover your crotch?
Yeah, pretty close. You actually put your crotch on your
cajones.
Cajon.
It's a wooden box that has a snare thing in it.
Yeah, I think you were telling me about this.
And so you play it almost like a damn drum set.
Yeah.
Wait, what? How does it work?
So it's basically a box, you know, roughly, I think like 15 inches high, 9x9. And it's, some of them are chambered. So as you play this thing, you got your highs and your lows. And then they've also got a snare thing hanging in there with the little chains. So you can, you know, you got something a little bit higher that you can hit and make it sound like a snare drum, and they sound quite amazing.
Huh, what do you do for cymbals?
And some of the folks have got like a little thing on their foot.
Oh.
Some just bring a single cymbal to do the cymbal.
Okay.
And a stick, you know.
And how much do these things run?
As cheap as like $40.
Yeah. Really? Is there like higher end ones though?
Oh yeah, I mean you can spend hundreds on them, but most of them are, they're like, hey, no, just start with the basic thing. And they've got a couple different designs. Basically, you know, essentially you sit on it.
Oh, so it's like one of those one box things.
Yeah.
Yeah, I've seen them. Yeah, well, this
but
is
it's modified.
Yeah, it's a modified version of it.
Yep. And then they make one that kind of goes across your lap, almost like bongos, but has the same thing, has a little built in. So you hit it at a certain spot and it does a little shh. So
that's pretty cool. Yeah. I've never even seen that.
Yeah, because you can't, you know, you can't take your drums on the road with you.
And so I've been meaning to play with my son-in-law, because he plays guitar. And we've always been trying to get together to do the drum thing. Well, it's just logistics-wise, I can't move my crap, and he's got the family and stuff, so it's tough for him to get down here. So right. I thought, well, fuck it. I'll just buy this thing, and next time we go, I got a little traveling drum set.
Can you, does that have the option to plug it in? Mm-hmm. So you can put it through, like, a PA kind of deal?
Yeah, some do. Some okay. got the pickup on them, and some don't.
I'm very curious to see what these things are like. So I got to watch a video.
Yeah, or... absolutely. I mean, it's interesting, the sound it's they get out of that box.
Cajon?
C-A-J-O-N, Cajon.
Cajon.
Which okay. I think is very close to, like, testicle or ball in the Spanish language.
So that's because you put them underneath your balls, right?
Yeah.
Huh. Pretty much, yeah, you teabag the thing. And
just, I'm teabagging all around is pretty awesome.
Can't go wrong with a teabag.
Depends who you do it to.
Oh, two.
I'm just like bang, bang, clang, 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 clang. I'm a professional.
The janitor's coming through.
I'm sorry, you fellas broadcasting in here.
Now I know I don't need any post-production and sound effects because I got you two here.
Side joke for if any of my friends are listening from our Canterbury days. Oh, what the hell? I just had to do that real quick.
So a handful of people out there are going to chuckle when they hear that.
Yeah, that's nice. Four.
That's funny. Perfect.
But if something comes up like every 5 or 6 years, oh, Jesus. Okay. Sorry, I had to do that.
The phrase that pays.
You know what works really good, you guys, when we're like podcasting or broadcasting, whatever you want to call it, is when we just like do a lot of inside jokes.
Yeah, because everybody gets them. Right.
Everybody.
Yeah.
It's universal. Everybody has inside jokes.
Yeah.
I know how much I love hearing them from other people.
We'll have to send out a decoder ring. Okay, kids, this is episode 15. Yeah.
It'll be like just a
side cliff
synopsis
notes.
Synopsis right. of our
yep.
cliff notes.
Cliff notes, yeah, that's good.
I don't have enough time to listen to this whole
episode
pile
two
of gibberish.
Of the Flummery, you'll notice that he talks about, what the hell?
People be signing off right away.
On episode one, he's in a weirdly pronounced swaint. Swaint.
I heard that too. That was funny. Making up words.
Swaint. I've made up a lot of words in my life. Do all guys do that, right? Like, mm-hmm. Do you do that with your buddies?
Yeah, I didn't come up with this, but in college we had Team Gash.
Wait, where is this going?
It's from River Falls.
Team Gash?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Well, it's Guys Against Sexual Harassment. It was a club, and I got invited into the club. I was a freshman, and it was all these seniors, but I knew some of them from high school. And they're like, are you going to be in Gash with us? And I'm like, what's that? They're like, Guys Against Sexual Harassment. It just can't happen. I mean, it was just more of a drinking thing.
Right.
You know, okay. Just at the party.
I didn't know what to think. I'm like, if this is a real thing, that's cool.
It was.
Okay.
Card-carrying member.
Yeah, it just became, I'm going to drink with you. All right, you're a Gash member.
Nice.
Can't sweet. Talk. What's the first rule of Gash?
No one talks about Gash.
Don't talk about Gash.
Right. You don't want to use that word, especially when you're trying to not sexually harass.
Get jackets made.
Team Gash.
Gash.
Okay, I like the idea.
Yeah, that was a River Falls thing, Adam.
Really? You know what else is a River Falls thing?
What?
Cow tipping.
The Blowjob Bandit.
What's that?
It is an ag school, by the way. Okay. You've never heard of the Blowjob Bandit?
No, is that a real thing?
It's, urban legend, but I might know a person who did it.
Was this? Are you talking about a chick?
Yeah.
Or there was a dude that was in.
Well, I don't know, but the story is it's a chick, where like somebody passes out shit ass wasted on a three season porch, and they wake up and it's like the sun's coming up and the person's kind of obscured that's in their pants sucking their D, and they're like, what the hell? And then they just skitter off. Oh God.
This is a real thing?
Well, I think it's an urban legend, but
yeah,
I did hear of somebody...
Was this at the Nut House?
...doing it. I don't know. I don't remember all the houses. I hung out at the basketball house.
We talked about that. I dated a chick that lived there.
Yep, yeah. She was awesome. We don't shouldn't use names on that.
No. No, it was a former basketball house, and these group of girls moved into there.
Kept the name.
Yeah, and they kept it a party house.
I can't believe we were talking about that. I had partied there very frequently.
Yeah.
And then I lived at the...
I wasn't a big fan of house parties for the most part. I went to them, but I was really tired of, like, struggling to, like, get to the keg.
Yeah, that sucks. I like the ones where you're in a place and... There's about 30 people there.
I was a bar guy. I like to go to the bar.
Hmm. Yeah. I liked both, but I didn't like the ones that are just packed.
Yeah, those are dumb.
They suck.
It's like going to a bar that's packed.
Right? Yeah, I like walking around and there's like 30, 40 people there and everybody can get to the keg and some people are playing. Like you sit down at the table.
There's a nice medium. Orders. There's a nice medium in a group
room
of people.
To do drinking games or whatever. Or...
That's kind of like having a podcast. Maybe three is too much.
What are you trying to say?
Well, I'm no math magician.
There's not three of us
what
here.
Are these things?
This is just
not like
one person
other.
With three different personalities.
It's just one. We're one entity with three dicks.
Oh.
Scoot, what about your partying days? Your keg partying days.
I can't talk about those.
Oh.
Well, that's no fun.
Now you have to.
Yeah. Signed, sealed. Yes, we used to do a lot of...
The cops tell you not to talk about it?
No. We used to do a lot of keg parties in the day. That was the thing. That was if you needed to raise some money, you had a keg party.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, the pickle in River Falls, that's how they would pay for their vacations.
Yeah, I knew
the slippery
a couple guys
pickle.
That live there.
Nice.
Yeah, so they would literally pay for their rent and pay for their vacation down in Lake Cancun.
Sweet.
That's insane.
That's how much money those guys would make.
Holy shit.
They would have a party every weekend and would pay for their rent, and then they would have an extra, and they would put that into a fund to all of them go on vacation together.
Huh.
Boom.
That's pretty awesome.
And it was in a weird... It was on Main Street there, just past that river bridge.
How did
remember
they have
that?
A party every weekend? Yo, I know right where it is.
They were secluded enough, like it wasn't, they had neighbors, but they weren't that close by. So like it was kind of advantageous for them. So they wouldn't really be a huge disturbance, you know?
How do you think, their neighbors was a dentist office.
Yeah, it was a dentist
office.
Like,
how do you think the people pulling in, like they pull in and instead of parking like facing the building, they take the spot that's facing the pickle and they're like, just shout. It looked like there was a beer can rain shower that night. For by 7 a.m. Dentist appointment, and you're seeing that like, fuck you. Kids.
I would go over there and watch like football or hang out during the day, you know, and stuff. And I remember like hanging out and walking in the living room. I only did a handful of times because after that one time, I mean, it's gross. Can you imagine living in like?
I did live in.
It was gross. A house it's where gross.
Partied pretty hard.
So when I was in college, we almost started to have a house like a. House party, like a house that was for house parties.
Where did you live?
On 3rd, next to DTS.
Okay. So right there where...
There's four houses on that block.
Yeah.
There's big, four big
houses.
Yeah,
right behind...
Bo's and mine.
Yes, Bo's. Yep.
So I live there. And we started having parties and DTS got mad at us and they started calling the cops on us. So we made good money one night and it was like, this is not worth it. And they had the cops call us and the cops came to us. Saying, we got a noise complaint. And I'm like, I'm the one that's dealing with the cop. I walked outside and I go, do you hear that next door? There's a fucking party going on next door, too. He's like, well, we got a call about you guys. And I'm like, oh, you're not playing a little favoritism here?
So you just pull out your phone and like, all right.
So you know what we did?
I'd like to call in the noise complaint.
You know that sign that was hanging? It was like an ox. You know, they put two oxes on that wooden thing with a cradle. Mm-hmm. That was like their
I walk by
sign.
There all the time.
Yeah, we stole that.
Oh, dude, you just opened up a can of worms.
And we painted it pink. And they would awesome. They'd come by and they're like, have you seen that? And then one night we hung it up like at 3 a.m.
That's awesome.
Nice. Were they scurrying about
fuck
like little
DTS.
Busy bees?
Fuck you. You fucking suck. Hope you all...
What does DTS stand for?
Delta Theta Sigma or something.
I want to be in a frat.
And then there was another one next to that, which was
sorry.
More.
It's okay.
I joined Phi Sigma Kappa, and then I got out of there.
Way to go.
because I realized I didn't have to pay. Most of them were my friends, and I realized I didn't have to pay to party with them because I just go party with them anyways.
Yeah, what's the point in paying?
That's not like the point of a frat, though, right? Isn't it supposed to be like I'm networking to be?
Yeah, it was just a party.
An Illuminati.
Yeah. I went through initiation too.
Skull and crossbones.
Oh, why? Why do people do it?
I'll never forget that. We had one of those old washing machines, like the one of the legs and the
right.
Just open that
ringer and shit. Yeah.
Clean that out and put a punch in it. Mm. That punch was so potent that one of my friends, Farah, ended up going to the hospital because she was falling, passed out in the bathroom with her pants down, sitting on the toilet. And she woke up the next day with an IV in her. Oh. I was passed out on my floor with a like spaghetti puke next to me.
Spaghetti puke.
My buddy Seth, who was joined with me at the same time, he got written up from the RA because he was trying to put his contact
in the door.
So he's trying to find his door, and then when he's trying to open his door, he's using his contact container as a key. That's how fucked up he was.
He was just trying to see the lock.
I have stories.
Just little SERPs of me.
You know what's sad? I didn't go to school to River Falls.
He just hung out in town.
Yeah, not gonna lie, that's exactly what
Steve,
happened.
Steve, you want a beer?
I partied my ass.
One more beer.
Yeah. Uno mas.
Okay.
Might as well.
I'm going to give him one of your Coors Lights.
Yeah.
I'm going to be wrapping this up soon anyway.
Yeah. Everybody has got to pee. They're getting beers. We'll do a synopsis.
Good God.
Then give me one. Well, I'm up here.
You're running solo.
Let's talk about something that really bugged the shit out of me this week.
Now what is that?
Okay, I already talked about the reviewers, but I gotta ask, okay, why do they suck about it so bad? Like, when we talked earlier about the reviewers, like, it's okay to have differing opinions about style, cinematography, plot, preference, etc. Like, a lot of women like certain types of movies, a lot of men like other types of movies, type of thing. Like, when you see directors who are putting things in the movies that are like little eggs for you to catch before the shit actually goes down, or just little things like that help you speed up the understanding of the character. Like, that's awesome. Why? I don't get the mean-spirited review.
Ignorance.
Why bother?
Well, it's their own expectation that wasn't met, and so they're going to use that as their deal.
Right? Like, when you go to a movie, you kind of know what to expect, right? Or you just, like, think every movie you're going to go to is going to be the best movie ever, right? Like,
you hope so. I mean, if you're going to drop $13.
Well, now, yeah, especially. Yeah.
You'd really like to be entertained.
I went to The Hangover, and I was disappointed in it at first. I watched it again. It seemed like it was a little better. But I wasn't like, oh, this sucks, because I knew what to expect. I knew it was just going to be a bunch of campy, goofy shit that happens. Yeah. Like, you like college movies or something, you know what I mean? But only older people, you know? And I knew what to expect. So I wasn't like, oh, how dare you? This movie is wasting my money.
Awesome. Like, you want to talk about reviews and people being negative. Just look at the times around it. A lot of people are... We're in a weird time because I think there's a lot of weird negativity, but it's also a beautiful time at the same time. I just think that people, it's an entitlement for people these days. It's like these, they call them millennials. You ever watch these, see these kids?
Well, it's not just them though.
But I'm saying this is, they're getting it from certain things.
Well, and with our digital world, everyone has a podium for their opinion.
Yeah,
everyone can launch their opinion out there regardless of how ignorant it is. You know, they've got a voice now.
Yeah.
Which, again, falls into your... Well, it's a beautiful thing because everyone's got a voice.
And I don't mean to talk about certain friends or folks. People that I know, but
stop,
like...
Stop, I tell you, I'll come right across this fucking table.
No, I'm talking about...
I thought it was me.
No, there's...
just both kick his
kids
ass.
That are young, you know, like, people that are a little bit younger than me, and their Facebook posts are like, they're super happy at one moment, yeah, and then the next morning, yeah, it's like bipolar. Fuck my life, and
yeah,
it's like,
oh yeah.
Like, I see that so much, and yeah, I'm like, why are you posting yeah all that?
What are you gauging this on?
Like, yeah, I mean, your life is perfect, and then it's shit. Right. You know, it's like, you are definitely on a roller coaster. And thank you for telling me about it anyways on Facebook, because, like, I need a minute-to-minute update about your fucking yeah
also,
your
it's
mental
like,
health.
I don't really want to, like, one Facebook post isn't going to ruin it for you, right? But you don't really want to hang with people that are just so...
up and down?
Yeah, like, just so goofy, like that. I don't get it. I mean, don't get me wrong, I posted some shit on Facebook I probably shouldn't have, but...
I post weird shit all the time.
But I say all the weird shit, too. Like, if you know me, you're going to get that anyway.
Right.
It's yeah putting it on Facebook.
Your filter's a little less.
My filter is a little less, but I do... There are... you know, I have stipulations in what I do.
Right, exactly. You have boundaries and morals.
Yeah.
Right?
I think.
And I don't...
I have...
When I'm around you, I don't morals feel like you're like...
Like I'm going to kill you?
You're not a...
Because I'm going to kill you. Just kidding.
Please do. It's a good age to go. Well, I'm at a good age to
so
go.
So what you're
out
talking about is the guy who's on Facebook, or this, you know, 17-year-old kid. It's like, oh, my parents. This guy.
Well, I'm talking
car
about.
And then they get in.
Even
and it's
30-year-olds that I know are doing this shit.
Right, but this is an example.
Right.
Oh, my parents got me a car for my birthday. Oh my god! I get in the car, and they're like, and then the next day they're like, FML, my car doesn't have seat heaters.
Right.
It's like, oh, what you the fuck?
Fucking poor little bastard. God.
Like, we used to have, oh my God, the cars we used to drive and where I came from.
Yeah, like, I had total beaters.
Yeah.
Like,
and we were lucky to have cars. Like, people right in the city didn't have.
You were lucky to get your license at 16, and if you did, and you saved, like, a couple $100, you could buy, like, a fucking 82 S10 that was barely holding it together and fucking right drive around town.
Well,
you know?
My dad did give me a car. My parents gave me a car. But it wasn't, like, I mean, it wasn't very expensive, but I wasn't like, oh, this car sucks because it doesn't have this. When, yeah, my dad gives me a car for my birthday. Mm-hmm. It's a Mustang. And it's an 87, and this is like 92 or 91.
It's like a new car.
No, wait. What am I thinking here? Hold on. What year was it? It was like 93.
I don't know. Does it really matter?
68.
But it looked new. While it didn't look new, it was like all the paint was peeled off. And there was like little, there wasn't a lot of rust, but it was like there was a lot of paint peeled off. And he's like, oh, sorry, you know, the car looks the way it does, but it's a car, and it's really well, it's really mechanically good. And I'm like, are you kidding? It's a fucking car. This is awesome. Right. Maybe I'm entitled. Because then he goes, well, you can't have it for a week. I'm like, oh, crap. Okay, what's going on? He's like, well, I just got to take care of something. He takes it to the Ford dealership. There's a recall on the paint job.
Mm.
He gives him $75 to repair like a small rust spot. But this car is the same body style as the brand new ones at the time. So it's got a brand new paint job. It looks brand new.
Nice.
I'm like, what the fuck? This is awesome. But at first, I wasn't like, oh, so rusted. The paint's peeling off.
Yeah, like, it's that entitlement. Like, you
know,
yeah,
Bluetooth.
Like, I wasn't like that. I was like, sweet, I can drive this thing.
Steve, what was your first car?
So that was a good one.
It was a 1966 Plymouth Belvedere 2.
Oh, the 2?
Yes.
Yeah.
My little babushka. Was that Belvedere?
Yes.
Belvedere, come here, boy.
This show is racist.
Bought her for $75 from a neighbor.
Really?
Yes.
What else did you buy?
$75.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. And then I ended up.
You can get a microphone. You could get a podcast microphone for that.
Was this in the '80s?
Oh no,
'70s.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, no, I take that back. I guess it would have been 1980. Was
right
when I was driving.
Right.
Yeah.
On decade.
The cusp of my, yeah.
Wow.
My freedom.
$75.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Well, you used to be able to get
I have bar tabs like that usually.
Right?
Yeah, unfortunately you didn't.
I don't drink. Fuck.
What? No, don't worry.
Yeah, mine was kind of, I had a circus on wheels. I had a 84 S10 with a 350 in it.
You told me about that.
Yeah.
It's like a death machine.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'd race.
The wheels would shoot off the sides for real.
No, it was badass. And it was yellow with orange and red pinstripes. So they called it, people in school would say, that's the circus on wheels. And
what?
Fucking.
Did you have like a big loud muffler on it, too?
But I ended up rebuilding the engine. Like, I used to be a big gearhead, and I don't know.
Oh, there's a Camaro somewhere stashed away that I've heard tell of.
I had that pickup until a couple of years ago, and my dad sold it for me.
Oh, the little
Chevy? What did they sell it for?
Yeah.
The S10. Hmm.
He didn't like just tearing ass.
I think he got a couple, like $1,200 or $1,300 for it.
Really?
Yeah.
Holy shit.
The body was still good.
Well, I suppose the engine's worth like $800 or $900.
Well, I rebuilt it.
Oh.
$150.
So,
$280. Yeah.
The only thing that it needed was the exhaust needed to be redone on it because we redid the engine and I wanted to. I forget. I used to be huge, like Summit magazines, and I had my ideas, and I had my like Flowmaster fucking, you know, exhaust and stuff like that. Yeah, like I. That's how I am with like music now, like gear and stuff. Like I used to be that way with like. I used to be that way with car stuff. And now I just, cars are, I don't know, I'm so disenchanted.
Necessary
like,
evil.
My dad, I grew up around my dad. My dad had me pulling wrenches when I was 6 years old on a Cummings engine. And he's like, oh, I got this car, let's work on this and blah, blah, blah. And I loved it when I was in high school.
But I want to play guitar.
Yeah. Was that the little voice inside my head?
Something very similar to it.
I had plans. My life is ruined.
But I'm supposed to talk to Marcia on the phone for 4 hours today.
Then I got out of college and sat in a cube for 2 years, and I was like, fuck that.
Right? Office space.
A cube?
I sat in a cube.
Did you sit in a cube?
In a cube.
Yeah.
What was it? What did you do?
I was a graphic designer for an embroidery company. Huh?
Embroidery though.
Yeah, for in Plymouth.
It's a cool graphic designer's cool.
It was a small company, but it was like successful. We dealt with clients all around.
It's called So What?
No, it's called Starbird Incorporated.
So okay. What?
Sorry. Wait, that's a real thing.
So what? So what?
Not the song. Right. There's actually a so what.
No, I know. That's what I mean. That's
he was played it beautifully.
We would do big, you know, we'd have big accounts with like Cisco, you know, big.
Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah, we would like.
Sorry, you guys. I'm sorry.
Anyways, the job sucked.
Go on with your story. I'm such a dick.
It was a nice like business building in Plymouth, and I had a pretty posh job, and I was like, I can't do this anymore. I can't.
Yeah, so I mean, Lance designs all the stuff you see on the website and stuff, like the Flummery logo, and then the picture of our setup and where he puts
very artistic,
superimposes the Flummery thing. He does it for his band too, and I can't imagine like that's the kind of job you should have got, right? Is working for maybe a music label or like a advertising.
I actually
agency.
Worked for First Avenue for a month or two.
Well, yeah, that'd be cool too.
And I did advertising.
Oh. Exactly, like the embroidery thing just doesn't match.
The pay was shit
at First Ave.
Yeah, because I would design all the, like the flyers and posters for First Avenue.
There's a job opening for that because the dude that did all the Godsmack's artwork passed away. Godsmack, and then there's a couple like five other bands that he did. In fact, I think Sevenfold was one of the groups that he did the artwork
those
for.
Are cool.
That makes sense.
That's why I remember Sevenfold.
Because that's the guy who does, like, you know, Godsmack and Avenged Sevenfold kind of are on the same lines. They are.
Not better though.
I'm not talking about better. I'm just talking about like type of music.
Godsmack is he's got a problem with people being too close to him. He's like, keep away from me. So get out of here.
Oh, you're just talking about their songs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It doesn't sound like the same theme to me.
Yeah, if you're Tool, you talk about how you want California to fall off into the ocean and learn to swim.
Even though, yeah, he lives there and he has a winery now.
Well, he's got his winery in Arizona.
He's such a pompous ass. Like, brilliant, but
really?
He's a pompous ass.
Yeah, yes. he's
brilliant, but that's how those guys are usually.
I love his... Maynard's got a wonderful voice.
Fucking.
He's... Out of those three bands we're talking about, Maynard kills them. And
oh,
vocals.
Yeah. I mean, they're, of course. He's... Like, genius, but it's just, you know, my buddy Cody's gonna hate me, but he's just a pompous ass. Like I watched the documentary about his winery. And he's like,
From Blood to Wine or whatever it's called.
Oh my god! I'm like, shut up. By the end of it, I'm like, just
I
sing.
I loved it.
Just sing.
Hey man,
shut up and sing.
He built that like that was part because
it's cool. You know,
it is. Just, he did that for his mom.
Oh boy.
Oh well, he didn't say that in the documentary.
Yeah, he did.
Now don't you feel like a shit heel?
No, not really. He's still a douche.
His mom's name was Judith, and he named one of his wines Judith.
Oh, I thought
which is a song on A Perfect Circle.
Well,
too.
I thought he had a third band called Judith Priest.
That was pretty good. Oh man! On that note, I think we should wrap this up here, guys.
Say, that's the end of the flummery for today.
Wrap it up, Steve.
Oh no, I wasn't. I'm sorry, I wasn't pulling the rug off like, on you guys.
Steve's head's about to hit the table.
Big three
right
today,
now.
You guys. Yeah, I mean,
what time did we get here? It's like 6 o'clock in the morning. Okay.
I had the weirdest dream. Yeah.
I had this large black thing in my eye.
That's a call of microphone.
Hi, Mike.
Okay.
Well, that wraps up the flummery for today.
Right.
I'm Lance, your
Scuba Steve.
And your
Frosty.
All right, you guys have a good day.
Frosty.
Miles of barbed wire. I got a cobra snake for a necktie. A brand new house along the roadside, and it's a made out of rattlesnake hide. Got a brand new gin that baby built on top, and it's a made out of human skull. Come on, take a little walk with me.